When I was growing up, the World's Fair and World's Expos were a big deal. But did you know Cleveland once had its own version of this kind of big exposition? If you're as surprised as I am, then you'll want to be exposed to John Vacca. John's the author of Meet Me on Lake Erie, Dearie, which travels back in time to when tourists came to Cleveland for a very big event. Thanks for joining us, John.
Pleased to be here.
So these expositions took place in Cleveland in 1936, 1937. Why the timing there?
Partly because it was the 100th anniversary of Cleveland's incorporation. At least that was the official reason, but mm-hmm. The real reason, I think, was to bring some money into the city in the middle of the Great Depression.
Give us an idea how big this Lake Erie Exposition was.
It was the biggest show Cleveland ever put on. It stretched from the mall all the way down to the lakefront. They built a wide bridge across the railroad tracks. And then along the lakefront from the old municipal stadium all the way down to what's now Burke Lakefront Airport.
Wow.
The WPA dug a tunnel under East 9th Street to connect the two sections.
Wow. So we have a tunnel underneath. We have a bridge over it. It sounds like things that we could use today to help bring back the lakefront.
As a matter of fact, I think that's where the idea started, that we really ought to take a look at the downtown lakefront and make it more people-friendly.
How many visitors came to the expo back then?
The first year they had about 4 million, I think.
4 million?
Just a few thousand under that.
It would take a few years for the Browns to bring that many people to Cleveland.
Yes, it would. Even the Indians haven't done that well.
That's a lot of people.
That's right. The second year, a little bit less, about 3.5 million. They had a lot of rain that summer.
What kind of exhibits did they have there? What brought so many people?
They had industrial exhibits, of course, and business exhibits, Ohio Bell, for example.
What are we looking at in this picture here?
I think the thing I'd like to bring back the most would be Streets of the World. They took 36 nationalities and packed them into a 10-acre
wow.
display.
Looks a little bit like Epcot in Disney World.
Rather. Chicago had a Belgian village and a German village, but Cleveland decided to put them all together in one display.
Wow, look at all that.
Covered 10 acres of exhibits. That's the midway that we see there. That went from East 9th all the way to Streets of the World.
Wow, look at all the people, how they're crowded in there.
Yes, they are. That's
wow.
the bridge over the railroad tracks.
And there was entertainment, too?
Quite a bit of entertainment. They had everything from Shakespeare to strippers. And the second...
I won't ask what brought more people. you don't have to ask.
You don't have to ask. And the second year was marked the debut of Billy Rose's Aquacade.
Huh.
Most people associate that with the New York World's Fair of 1939, but Cleveland had it first.
And I understand there were a lot of bands. Xavier Cugat came. And
a lot of them were connected with the Aquacade.
Oh, interesting.
They would put on a water show, lasted about an hour, and there's Billy Rose and his star, Eleanor Holm, mm-hmm. and the third man there was familiar to a lot of people in the 30s. That was Johnny Weissmuller.
Tarzan
of the movies.
Very good. Well, it's a fascinating book. You've done obviously a lot of research. Very interesting. Thank you for coming on and presenting it to us. Appreciate that.
Thank you.
All right, Meet Me on Lake Erie, Dearie. It covers a unique time in our town's history. My thanks to John Vacca for giving us this world-class tour of Cleveland's world-class expos.
To find out more, call Kent State University Press at 330-672-7913 or log on to www.kentstateuniversitypress.com. Next, words of wisdom for healing wounds.